Good morning, children. Today we are going to start off with a new topic, and I'm sure you're going to enjoy the topic which I'm going to do, but I'm not going to tell you which topic I'm going to do. You have to tell me. Okay. If I say she is a girl, so what will you say? He is a girl or a boy? Yes. So boy and girl. Now you tell me man and if it's a man, we call it a man. But a lady, we call it, what do we call it? Woman. Right? A gentleman, if we say, so what is the, what do we call a girl? Gentleman, here we call it lady. Right? So what are we doing? Children, these are all nouns. So, you already know what are nouns, right? But nouns in the form of gender. What is a gender? What is a gender? Who can tell me? Gender means male or female. We can also call it as masculine and feminine. Okay, masculine and feminine gender. So, we are going to learn today about genders. Okay, so let's do that. I would just request you to take out your grammar book. We are going to start off with the grammar book today. Right? Page number 27, the noun gender. Are you ready? Yes. So let's start off. Look at the following sentences. So let's read the sentences which are there in the book. Please follow with your fingers and I'm going to explain it to you. Ravi is an honest boy, right? Archana, Ravi is a boy. Archana is a pretty girl. So children, can we say that Ravi is an honest girl? And Archana is a pretty boy. Can we say that? No. Because a girl is a girl. We have to refer to him as a, her as a girl. And a boy, we refer to him as a boy or a man or a gentleman. Or we refer to a girl as a girl or a woman. Or a lady, right? So that is where the difference is. These are all nouns, but these are all genders. How it is different? See, male and female. Can you call your mother? She's a lady, right? Can you call her father? No. You have to call her mother. Okay? So let's do that. So a noun that is the name of any male person or animal is said to be of the masculine gender, as a boy, man, uncle, bull. These are all masculine. Even animals have. I will just teach you sometime later once I introduce the topic to you properly. See this sentence, Archana and girl are the names of females. Like a noun that is the name of any female person or animal is said to be of the feminine gender. Right? As a girl, woman, aunt, cow, okay? Letter and pen. Okay, there is one more sentence C which was there on top. He wrote a letter with the pen. See, there are no male and female here. But what is there? Letter and pen are nouns, right? A noun that is the name of a lifeless object is said to be of the neuter gender. Any lifeless object, non-living thing is a neuter gender. Like mobile, desk, file, magazine, chair, fan, table, anything you see. These are all lifeless, right? Okay. Now see, there's a next sentence. Children should respect their elders. Children is a noun. Elders is a noun. But see, children and elders are words that can be used for both males and females. So our children can be a boy and or a girl, right? Like elders can be a man or a woman. So both can be elders. I'm sure I'm able to make you understand. Dono ho sakte hain. Bachcho mein ladki bhi ho sakta hai, ladka bhi ho sakta hai. So both are there. So in this case, what do we do? A noun that is the name of an animal or person that may be either male or a female is called common gender. If a man or a woman can be same, like a teacher can be a man or a woman. So the word teacher is a common gender, right? So what are neuter genders? These are all, this is masculine gender, feminine gender. What is a neuter gender? I told you these are all what? Lifeless and non-living things like pen, chair, bed. Okay, and what's a common gender? Common gender is when a person can be both, like a teacher. Teacher. A teacher can be a man or a woman. Okay, like doctor. A doctor can be a man or a woman. Like children. Children can be a boy or a girl. Okay? I'm sure I have made you understand this. Now children, let's read a few lists of it. See, page number 27, the first list. Some feminine nouns are formed by a change of word like boy with boy. The boy is masculine, then feminine is girl. So boy, girl, brother, sister, bull, cow, husband, wife, king, queen, lord, lady. Turn the page. Page 28. Some feminine nouns are formed by adding ess to the masculine, like author becomes authoress, like heir becomes heiress, host becomes hostess, leopard becomes leopardess, the tiger becomes tigress, like this. See, tiger is the male. We add T-I-G-R-E-S-S. So E-S-S we add here. It becomes tigress. Right? So there's a list given in your book. Please go through it. Lion, lioness. Manager, manageress. Peer, peeress. Poet, poetess. Priest, priestess. Shepherd, shepherdess. Steward, stewardess. Discount, viscount, viscountess. Okay. Now, next section is where you add ESS after dropping the vowel of the masculine end. Just see. Actor becomes actress. In this section, we were only adding ESS. Now, see. Actor, A-C-T-O-R. So, we are dropping the R here and we are writing A-C, A-C-T-R-E-S-S, actress, even tigress. Okay? Even this. Right? Like here, we did not change anything. I will just show you. Author. This is author, means who writes stories. So author, we don't change anything here, we just add. A-U-T-H-O-R-E-S-S. We just add him. But here we drop this R and we add E-S-S. See? Okay? Like actor, actress. Conductor, conductress. Duke, duchess. Emperor, empress. Founder, foundress. Hunter, huntress. Prince, princess. Songster, songstress. Seamster, seamstress. Tiger, tigress. Traitor, traitress. Waiter, waitress. Master, mistress. And sorcerer, sorceress. Okay? Now see, some feminine nouns are formed by the replacing of word before and after the masculine word. Like, grandfather becomes grandmother, great uncle becomes great aunt, landlord becomes landlady, peacock becomes peahen, manservant becomes maidservant, billy goat becomes nanny goat, boyfriend becomes girlfriend, washerman becomes washerwoman, right? So we are adding. There is a common word for all the animals and special words for the male. Like, there are some words for bees. Like, see, there's a common word and there are masculine and feminine. Like, bee becomes drone and queen drone. Queen bee. Cattle becomes bull and cow. Dog becomes dog and bitch. Duck becomes drake and duck. Right? So these are a few things which we have. I have just explained to you and I'm sure you understood the concept of it. And male, female. So there are, I'll just revise it a little for you so that the concept is a little clear. Male, female, masculine, feminine, gender. There are two types of genders. Masculine, feminine. And there are more neuter and common. So there are four genders. What are the four genders? Masculine gender, feminine gender, neuter gender and common gender. Right? Okay. Now, in masculine gender, boy, we represent male. And feminine gender, we represent female, which is a boy and a girl. In a neuter gender, what do we represent? All the lifeless things and non-living things, right? So, like pen, chair, bed, I told you. These are all anything you name of. These are all new to gender. And common gender, like a teacher who can be both a male or a female. Like a chef who can be both a male or a female. Okay? So, these are all common genders. I'm sure you understood. Now let's go for the exercise. Children, page number 29. Take out your pencil. We are going to solve it in the book. Okay? write the gender of each of the following words. Page 29, A, section A. Quickly take out your book, by then I'm going to rub the board, okay? Right. So, section A, 1, pencil is the first one is already done for you. You have to write the which type of gender it is. Pencil is a neuter gender, we know, because it is a lifeless thing or a non-living thing. Knife is also a non-living thing. So, sorry, number 2 will be bitch. Number 2, okay, let me just write it like this. This is neuter. Number 2 is a bitch. It's a female. So, feminine gender. Right? Number 3 will be knife. Knife is lifeless, non-living. So, it is neuter gender. Number 4, cattle. Cattle is a common gender because a cattle may be male or a female. It can be. So, it's a common gender. Number 5, niece. Which is a female gender, which is feminine gender. Fowl. Fowl is a bird. Fowl can be a male or a female, so it's a common gender. Number 7. So children, number 7 is a stick. Stick is a non-living thing. So it is neuter gender. Number 8. Mobile. Mobile is also a non-living thing. So it is also a neuter gender. Also a boar and V. Okay. These are all what? A ram and a V. Sheep. Sheep is the common gender and we call it a male, we call it ram, and a female we call it V. Okay. The spelling is E-W-E. So it is a feminine gender. And the last one is sheep. Sheep is, I told you, a common gender. Yeah. Right? I'll give you some time. Please write it down. And then we are going to go to the next section. Right, children, I'm sure you have done the needful. It was very simple. I'm sure you have understood the concept. Now let's do the next section. Fill in the blanks with masculine and feminine nouns. We are going to do this section. We are going to write the masculine and the feminine. Okay? But children, we are not going to do the crossword. Then complete the given crossword. So we are not going to do the crossword because there's some mistake in the crossword. Okay? So we are just going to do this section. Right? Am I clear? Okay. Let's start off. So first one, aunt becomes So first let's do the down one. 1 to 7. Or whatever you want to do the across. Let's do the across. Should I lap the board? I'm sure you all have finished by now. Okay. So children, first we are going to do the across one. This one is not working. Across, A-C-R-O-S-S, across, okay. First we are going to do the across. And down. But children, we are not going to do the crossword. Okay? So masculine and feminine. Masculine and feminine. Right? So now we are going to do the answers. Number 8. I'm just going to write the answer for you, okay? So, masculine, aunt becomes uncle. So, in this blank, please write uncle. Man becomes woman. Lady, gentleman, then stallion. Horse is the common gender. Stallion is the male and mare is the female, right? So we write mare here. 12, 12. Master becomes mistress. Wizard. Duck becomes Drake. D-R-A-K-E. Okay? Done. This is, now we are going to do the down one. Okay, let me just rub this. It's going to be masculine, feminine, both. So, number one. Authoress becomes author. A-U-T-H-O-R. Author means a writer. Right? Monk becomes nun. So, a niece becomes nephew. Okay? Number 4. A hen becomes a cock. Number 5. Ram becomes wheat. comes aboard. This is for the pig, okay? 7, landlady becomes landlord. 8. These are the ones. Please write it down. I'll just give you some time to finish it off. Okay, right, children. Do you need more time? Okay. Some more time to you. Right, so I'm sure you have finished this and you have finished the exercise here. There is not much exercise in the book. I'm sure you have understood the concept of gender. There are 4 types of genders: masculine, feminine, common and neuter. A common gender has both male and female in it, like a teacher can be a male and a female. A student can be a girl or a boy. So, the word student, the word teacher, the word doctor, these are all common gender. And neuter gender, very simple to remember. All non-living things, all lifeless things like desk, whatever you can just see, they are non-living. They are all neuter gender, like door, then a cupboard, curtains, mobile phone, pen, pencil, book, notebook, bag, car. These are all neuter gender. Okay, and male and female, which is masculine gender is male and feminine gender is female. Masculine gender is a girl. Masculine gender is a boy. Feminine gender is girl. Right? So, these are the way we have distinguished and the types of genders. So, I'm sure you have understood this. If you have any issues, please get back to me. I can, you know, explain it to you next time if you have any queries. Children, right now I just give you a few little homework which I'm sure you're going to enjoy doing it. Just Google, and since you have understood the concept of genders, and there are how many types of genders are there? So, let's make a list of it, okay? I will be giving you a list in my next video, but let's see what you can find out on your own and how much you have understood the concept of genders. Okay, so make a list. I'm just going to rub it and I'm going to show it. Do it in your notebook. You can take help from your mom. You can Google and then just get the list. So, first one would be common gender. Common gender. Okay. You do one common gender. 10 common genders. Okay.
take out from Google.
10 common genders, 10 neuter genders. Then 10 masculine and feminine. Okay, so let me see what you find out, and please do it in your notebook and click it and send it to me personally, okay, so that I can check. Right, children, so I end my lecture here today. I'm sure you have understood and you have no issues. So stay home, stay safe, take care of yourself, study, go through the videos, children, please, so that you can learn better and have a wonderful day. Thank you so much.